I think people should be able to make the decisions that they would like to make for themselves. I don't want to encumber someone's ability to make their decisions. I don't want to tell anyone how to live their lives. I also think that when government gets involved in something, and there is so much proof of this as to almost be indisputable, the minute government gets involved in something, it makes it more complicated and it makes it more expensive. And usually the loser is the citizen. The two examples, not to get back to healthcare, but healthcare and education. The two areas where government has gotten deeply involved is in healthcare and in education. And the two areas that are the most expensive for any American, not just in this state, in all states, is healthcare and education. My view is that the private market handles things because interests are aligned in a more efficient and better way. We all have technology in our pockets, which is greater than what it took to put a man on the moon in 1969. But to get an education, which is still done with regular textbooks, is skyrocketing. We're subsidizing it over and over in order to keep tuitions low, but the cost is high. And the number one reason for debt among young people in this country is exorbitant university fees.
So let me ask you this. If your guiding philosophy is to keep government out of people's lives, mm-hmm. Do you believe that a woman has a right to decide the fate of her own body when it comes to issues such as whether or not to have an abortion?
Well, the challenge there is that there are two lives involved. So where I believe that we should stay out of people's lives, I don't believe that people's lives should be taken. And so it's a complex issue because one has to think, well, there's a host body, and that host body has to have a certain amount of rights because at the end of the day, it is that body that carries this entire other body to term. But there's an additional life there. And the question that we have to ask ourselves is, in protection of life, and we do that in all our laws, all parties protect life, what is the limit to which we are going to give one person complete power over the life of another? It's a complicated issue. I wish it would fit neatly into libertarian thinking the way a lot of other things do. The truth is it doesn't.
So
but there are two lives involved.
So if Roe versus Wade is overturned, or if states are allowed more control over this issue, would you favor banning abortions in the state of Florida?
What I would favor is, one, understanding viability. So we have to look at a couple of things. In a situation of incest, rape, I mean, they're one and the same. But in those types of situations, traumatic experiences, minors that are raped and impregnated, we're talking about there are deep psychological effects there. And we have to look at, is one life worth more than the other there? But make no mistake about it, we are making a decision between two lives. And so I don't want to disguise it. What I'm saying is that in the event
of... Do you believe life begins at conception?
I believe science believes that. I mean, the only definition of science of life is something that grows. From the moment that conception occurs, there begins to be growth. And so scientifically, that's what it is. But that's not the question. The question is, what is the value of that life, and is it subordinate to the value of its host body?
So is the question viability then? So in other words, you would allow abortion up until the point where the fetus was viable?
No. What I've said is that if the life of the mother is in danger, or in the case of a minor who has been raped or the mm-hmm. victim of incest rape, the mental capacities of that person are deeply in danger. Those are things we should look at. But viability is also very important. As technology moves along, a human body can exist outside of its host body earlier and earlier. And so then one has to think, to what time does the host body have veto power over this other life?
You realize there are a lot of people who will hear you use phrases like host body and say to you, that's a woman, that's a person.
Yeah.
You're sort of creating a scenario where you're looking at that not so much as a person, but as a host body.
Well, yeah, You understand that when this discussion is being had, the fetus is also a person, and that is being seen as a fetus. And so we can either use technical terms on both sides, or we can just use both lives. I'd be happy to do either. The real question is, there are two lives. There is a weight and a quality to both. Both need protection. What is that balance?
Let me ask you this. Do you see bills talking about the issue of abortion and viability coming up in this session?
I think that they will, because of what we've seen nationally.
What do you think is likely to pass the House, and what would you support and what would you oppose?
I would support things that are consistent with other laws. So in the state of Florida, you cannot get a marriage license without a cooling off period of a couple of days, just to make sure that two capable adults are required to take some time. You're required to take a certain amount of time before you buy a firearm, just in the event that you are making a bad decision for yourself. They're adults, and so without any suspicion that this is a bad decision, you're supposed to take this time. We feel that it is an offense to ask someone before ending another life to take a time and think about it, to fully understand what it is, to share the information. So I think I would like something that is consistent with other things we do in our state.
The assumption that you're making, though, is that the woman has not given thought to it, that has not weighed her options, considered it, before walking into a clinic and making that choice. So you see what I'm saying? In other words, you're saying that after some people will hear that and say to themselves, the woman has already made that choice, wrestled with those decisions, decided this is what's in her best interest, walked into a facility, and now is being told you have to turn around, go home, and come back in 48 or 72 hours.
And the same argument can be made for a marriage license. The same argument could be made for the purchase of a gun. We're making assumptions that perhaps we probably should not make. But one thing that we have said as a state is, in these cases, we're asking you to give it some thought, because we think there is some measure of gravity. And what we're also saying is we'd like to provide you with as much information as possible.
All right.